Yeah, nice and comfy. Just remember, if you need to move the legs, we move the legs, no problem. So start to settle. Try to ground your hips. Pushing into the floor with your hips, lengthening the spine. Check that your shoulders and your arms are relaxing. And with that little pushing of the hips, start to visualize your roots, or you releasing the roots into the floor, or as always, we can imagine the roots already there. And we just release into the roots and we plug ourselves on those roots. So with those roots, we have that connection with the planet, yeah, the strength, the support, the resilience that we can absorb from the planet. Then we have that sensation of being secure and safe and balanced. And then we can absorb as well through the roots all the energy that we need, all the qualities that we need. And also imagine the roots like a recycle centers, where we will send all the tension, all the stress that we carry, and the roots will recycle that energy, will cleanse that energy, and it will give it back to you nice and fresh, renewed, recharged. So when we have that images, those images in place, start to focus on your breathing. And imagine starting the cycle of energy. Yeah? So when you breathe in, you receive the energy from the planet, the energy that you breathe, the energy around you. And imagine all that energy combined is going through your body, through your mind, through your heart, melting, dissolving tension, stress, worries. Anything that could be bothering you on the physical aspect and on the emotional aspect. And then imagine when you release it, that energy goes into the roots and again start the process again. Okay? So every breath, we have this circle, this cycle working for us. Yeah? So again, when you have the images in place of this cycle of energy, we can start to relax. Hands on the floor or on the legs, and let go completely. Soften your shoulders. Relax your neck, don't force it. And then we move the hands to one side. And then we go to the other side. And then we come back to the center. We put the hands behind, grounding your hips, open your chest. Shoulders away, breathing deeply. And then relax your chin to the chest. And relax. Now we bring the other leg forward. And we soften. And then we move the hands to one side. and then to the other side. And into the center, coming back. We put the hands behind and grounding your hips, open your chest. Breathing deeply. Open. And relax your chin to the chest. Ah, we soften. So in this position, we do that nice circle with your upper body. Keep grounding your hips and your legs. So use the movement to keep encouraging that grounding, that rooting into the roots, into the planet. And imagine with this circular movement, you receive a beautiful energy of loving energy or soothing energy, relaxing. A soft kind of energy to keep helping your body to release the tension that we carry. And then we go to the opposite direction. And then on the center, lengthen the spine, relax your shoulders, belly a little bit in, and we rotate and we expand, shoulders away. Keep the position. And we move the head, only the head, to the front and to the other side. And then back to the twist. And relax, release. And then again, lengthening your spine. And we start to rotate. Open. And keeping the position, we bring the head to the front and then to the other side. And then back to the twist. Relax, release. So we'll put the hands and the knees on the floor. Shoulders away, and we start to move the hips. So breathing forward, breathing back. And then the opposite direction. And then on the center, breathing and open arching, shoulders away. Breathe in deeply and breathe out and round. Take your time, open nice your spine, bring the head up and down, following your spine. When you round, try to squeeze a little bit more deeply your belly without tensing it too much. And then we curl the toes. We put the back of the toes on the floor, expanding, open. And then a squeeze. And again, breathing, expanding, open. And a squeeze. Good. And we go to child pose. We open the knees, we soften back. Relaxing. Relax your neck, your shoulders, your elbows. And then we move the hands to one side. And then we go to the other side. And then coming back to the center, we put the elbows on the floor, the flesh part, and hands in prayer position or above your head or your neck, and we soften chest, armpits, shoulder blades. And then relax. We put the hands again on the floor. And we go to relax the shoulder blades in the opposite direction. Bringing the arm beneath, shoulder on the floor, head, and then relaxing the arm. Softening, yeah? Letting go. And then we go to the other side. And then coming back to the center, shoulders away, and we will go slowly to downward facing dog, taking your time. So keep the shoulders away, bend the legs, and start to go back with your hips, opening your chest like a toe at your knees, your thighs, relaxing your head. Cool. So move it slowly, bit by bit, side to side, to make your upper body a little bit more comfortable. And then start to move the legs one by one, like you're walking on the spot. Good, very nice. And from there we will go to plank, keeping the belly in, heels as much back as you can, shoulders away. lengthening the back of the neck. Yeah? So try to don't arch on the plank. Try to keep the belly in. And then we go up and expanding open. As much back as you can go. Yeah? So we go forward again. Belly in. Hips tilting forward. Yeah? So don't arch here. Don't go too low, Rosalie. Bring the belly in. Yes. And try to squeeze your bum. And then up. Expand. Go. Well done. And we put the knees on the floor. And we will expand one leg back, shoulders away. Breathe in open and breathe out. Round. Breathe in open and round. And again. Go. And one more time. Go. And then we go with the other leg. Open. And round. And again. Good. And then we bring one leg forward. And we will relax forward. Hips. Release the shoulders. Yes, so open your foot, expand, open. And we open the chest and the arms without tensing. Yeah? So relax your shoulders, relax your hips. Expand. Expanding up. Yeah? So check also like you feel that you're stretching the sides as well of your body. We release, we put the hands on the floor or on the blocks, and we go with the heel on the floor, leading back. We can put the hands like this, or we can put one hand on the leg. Yeah? Don't force the knee. Even if you can, don't force. Keep going with the hips. Chest a little bit open. Cool. Well done. And then we change. We go with the other leg. So again, we move the hip forward. Yeah. Relax. Soften here. Yeah. Open your foot. Yeah, that foot is always open to create like a big base for your support. Yeah. And we expand. Shoulders away. Spread. And then we put the hands on the floor, or one on the floor and one on the leg or on the blocks. Hips back. Softening. Good. And then we will go forward. And we will go all the way up. Expanding. Good. And spread. Yeah? So lengthen the side. Now check again that your knees are not tensing. Yeah? Your feet nice and open, your toes. And stretching, feeling open in the side. Each side nice and deep. And then we will go with both arms to the side. Check that the knees are soft. Your shoulders are away. Expanding. And then we go to the other side. Spread. And then one more time up. Ah, relax, release. Well done. Better. Nice. We relax your shoulders, yeah? Soften. Good. And we move to the front. Good. And then back. So we'll work a little bit on the position for the Zoom salutation. So we will press, imagine that you press with your hands toward the floor. like you are in your upward facing dog. Yeah. So the chest are open and up. Your shoulder blades are more closer to each other. Yeah? You push to the floor to lift in this. This is engaged, but we are not hanging. Yeah? You press up. Okay? Then we will bring the arms up without moving the shoulders, like when you go to your downward facing dog. Yeah? So imagine that you have the hands on the floor there and you try to open the chest. When you are in the downward facing dog, this is the movement that we want. Yeah? So not this. You have your hands and then you try to open your chest. Yeah? Now we will relax forward. So this will be like your plank. Your plank is straight. Yeah? So we are not arching on the plank and we are not with the bum out. Yeah, straight. So belly in, your hips tilting forward. This is your plank. Yeah? So when you go to the upward facing dog, you bend your arms. The arms are squeezed toward your the shoulder blades together. The shoulders are away. Yeah? And then you push into your upward facing dog, belly in. This is all a squeeze, yeah? But we are not hanging on the lower back. Yeah? And then again, we go up to your downward facing dog, opening your chest, yeah? And release. So we'll try to use that during the Sun Salutation. Yeah? So we'll go to the top of the mat. Breathing, expanding, open, lengthen, shoulders away, spread, but nice and soft. Breathe out, hips out, belly, solar plexus, chest, head, neck, arms. We put the hands on your shins, we look up, open chest. So we go to your plank, remember the plank. Check that you are straight, that you are not here. So heels back, the hips are in. Okay? Then we put the knees on the floor. Here you can do the all fours, or we can try that bending and then pushing up, expanding, belly in, shoulders away, and then we go up. Cool. So once you are there, check that open of the chest. Yes, so move your chest and your shoulder blades, trying to go back toward your knees, toward your thighs. Yes, very nice. And we bring the right leg forward to warrior two, grounding. So keep the hips relaxing, your front knee facing the front. Yeah, yeah, well done. Shoulders. So we will, with the belly strong, we will go back first, expand, keep relaxing the hips, keep checking the front knee. So we are not arching the lower back, yeah? We try to relax the hips, yeah? And then we put this hand forward, and we bring this hand nice and long, like a toward the C front, expanding, yeah? A nice lengthen from the heel, yeah? So bring the hands a little bit more forward, Rosalie. Yes, and then up, warrior two, grounding on the center, and then we rotate, belly in, we go back to plank. So again, check your plank, it's straight, it's not arching, it's not up. Table. Put the knees and again chest and chin or all fours. Yeah? Expanding. Open. Shoulders away. We go up. Open, open, open. And we bring the left leg forward. Good. Very nice. So relax your hips. Spread. Keeping the hips going down, yeah? We will put the hand on the back leg, we open. Keep bending the front leg, yeah? Yes, forward, 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 forward. And then coming back, we go with the arm on the leg, And we stretch. Imagine that you want to stretch the side between your heel and your fingers, but not tensing, soft. Coming up, warrior two, settle again, rotate, back to plank, shoulders away, so lengthen. Knees and chest and chin, expanding open, shoulders away. We go up, spread, open. Open chest, yeah, toward the legs. And then we bring the legs forward toward the hands. And we go all the way up, expanding. And up. Well done. So we do it one more time. Breathing open. Expand. Lengthen. And then spread. Soften. Relax, let go, release. Breathing open, back to plank. Shoulders away, chest open. We go again, chest and chin. Expanding open, shoulders away. We go up. Expand open, so go far away with your hips and then work a little bit with your chest toward your thighs. Yes, a little bit more. Well done. We bring the right leg forward. We go to warrior two again. Settle. Relax. So we will go again back first, expanding, settle. Shoulders away. And then back to warrior two, and we move the hips back to go to triangle. Yes, so hips back, lengthening the thigh, lengthening the leg. We go forward, we rotate, we put the hand on the leg, and we expand and we spread. Open shoulders away. Yeah? Breathing deeply. Bending the front leg, relax the hip. We go one more time back, keeping the hips down, keeping the knee open, spread. Coming back, settle, rotate. Back to plank. Shoulders away, and we go. Chest and chin. Expanding, belly in. And then up. Open the chest. Yes, so really go back, 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 back. Yes. We bring the left leg forward. We go to warrior two. Go. So again, relax the hip, keep the knee open. Yes. We put the arm back, belly strong. We open. Soften. Keep relaxing the hips, yeah? And then warrior two, we press back with the hips. We move forward with the body. We put the hand on the leg and we expand. Remember not to block this knee, yeah? Spread, shoulders away, expand. Open. Bending the front leg. One more time back, keep relaxing the hip, open. Keep bending the front leg, yeah. Coming back. We rotate, back to plank. And again, yeah. So chest and chin, expanding open. Shoulders back, belly in. Lengthen the back of the neck, we go up. Back with your chest. Yeah, so bend the legs in tiny bit so you can open the chest over your thighs. Imagine that you want to put your boobs on your thighs. And we bring the legs forward toward the hands. And we go all the way up, expand and lengthen. Release, yeah? We do the last one. Breathe in, open. Expand. Open, 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 open. Breathe out, relax. Hips, belly, solar plexus, chest, head, neck. We go up again. Back to plank. Shoulders away. And we go chest and chin. Belly in, expand, open. We go up. Spread. We bring the right leg forward. And we will rotate to warrior one. Yes, so we will rotate the hips. We will face the front. Connecting, yeah, expand, shoulders away. Lengthen, yeah? So relax your hips. Open, spread. So not forcing the lower back, just going with the hips and keep expanding your size of your body as well. Okay? Now we will put the hands behind. Yeah? We will put hands or in prayer position, or here, or here, yeah? But having the shoulders rotated, so keep, check that your shoulders are not falling forward. Yeah? And from there, we will do like the triangle, we will push back, but we keep the center, so we stretch both legs, grounding, yeah? We are facing the front. So we will flex the hips, both legs are extending, yeah? And we will go with the belly, with the chest, with the head, working on the hip, yeah? And then we look up, open chest, connect, expand, open and spread. Lengthen. Both legs are extending but not blocking. We put the hands in prayer position. We will go again forward to warrior one. Rotating, yeah, belly strong. We lifting the hands without forcing the spine, yeah? And relax, back to plank. And again, yes, so chest and chin. Belly in, spread. Yeah, lengthen. We go up. Open back. Open your chest. Relax. We bring the left leg forward. Yeah, cool. So we will go to warrior one. Bending the front leg. Your hips facing the front. Lengthen by and squeezing here. Expand. Good, yeah, very nice. So really forward, yeah. Check that the back foot is more or less okay. Yes, well done. Very nice, expand. Okay. So press with that leg toward the floor, nice and strong, to ground and to spread. Very nice. Now we will put the hands behind. We can catch the hands. Yeah, shoulders away. So we push back. The same action at the triangle, but instead of open the hip, we keep the hip facing forward. So both legs are extending. We go hips out, belly is balancing, so that's okay. Yeah, that's what we are working. That's what we are working. So if you move, it's okay. Yeah. So we go belly, solar plexus, chest and head. Keep expanding your spine. Don't block the knee that is forward. Eh? Not too bendy, but a little bit, a tiny bit the leg, comfortable there. Now we go head, chest, you press into the legs, we expand, open, 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 open. And then we go forward again, relaxing the hips. We open, lengthen, spread, and relax. Back to plank. Well done. And we go chest and chest, chest and chin. Forward. Open. Belly in, shoulders away. We go up. Spread. Open. So go with the hips, with the belly, with the chest, with the head. And then relax in child pose. And soften. We can relax with the arms forward, with the arms beneath your forehead, or the arms beside your body. Surrendering deeply there. Letting go complete. Go. Well done. And from there, we will go to hero pose. Yeah? So we can sit in or on your blocks or on your legs. If this position is not comfortable at all, we can sit. Yeah? So we ground, shoulders away, belly in. Yeah? Yeah, take your time. Pushing into the hips wherever you have it, on the blocks or on your feet. Yeah? Relax your shoulders. So open chest, relax your arms. Stay a little bit there, yeah? Soften shoulders. We will open the arms softly, yeah? So check that you're not tensing, soft. Relax. Expand your chest. And we will bring the right arm above the left. We round here. We will cross, we catch the arms, and we will do like a little circles. Feeling the shoulder blades, trying to relax the shoulders away from your ears. And then the opposite direction. Good. Now we will open again. Soft, yeah? So start like with the chest, relax your arms, spread, soften your shoulders, breathe deeply, imagine that you are receiving all the energy that you need in that opening, and we will cross the left arm now. We soften, yeah? And up and down. Relax. Yeah. Well done. And then we spread. We open, shoulders away, expand. We put the hand behind. We put the hand behind. Spread open, shoulders away. Breathing deeply. And then spread back, shoulders relaxing. Put the hand, put the other hand, rotate the shoulder open and spread. And then relax. We will put the arms on the legs, soften shoulders, yeah? And we will bring the So keep the chest lifted, the spine straight. We bring the head to the chest and we will relax the head to one side and then to the other side. And again. And then come back to the center. We relax, yeah. We soft. We will stretch the legs, yeah. Nice and soft. And expand. Well done. So we will sit with the legs forward now. And we will do a little bit of forward bend. Oh. Well done. So try to check that you are comfortable on your hips, on your bum. Ground your hips and lifting your spine, your chest. So check that you are not falling behind. If you are falling behind, you lift in the knee and you are in your seat bones. Yeah? So doesn't matter, you stretch, you will stretch anyway. Yeah? So you are on your hips, lifting chest. We open the arms softly. Keep expanding into the hips and the spine, the chest. Yeah? And we will go forward as always. First the lower back, the belly, then the chest, then your hands, wherever you can, doesn't matter. Yeah? And then slowly your head. No forcing, okay? Softening. We are not tensing to force, yeah? We are relaxing. So you can stay still or you can breathe in, lifting a little bit your head and your chest. And on the breath out, relax again. Yeah, so, or still, or moving with your breath to soften the position. And in the next one, we will lift in the head, lift in the chest, we bring the arm forward. We press into the hips to go up, expanding, lifting, open, spread chest. Yeah? The same, this is always the movement that we want to move the chest and the solar plexus open. Yeah? And we will put the hands behind, keeping that expansion, shoulders away, and we spread even deeper without forcing, but really try to open. And then relax, release, well done. We will bring the other leg. And open. So we ground the hips, open your chest, yeah? Shoulders away, we lift in the arms. Yeah, connect, yeah? So check if you need to bend the leg or not. And then we move with your belly, with your solar plexus, with your chest, wherever you can put your hands. Doesn't matter how much or where, yeah? Soften, so we can stay still there, or we can do breathing open, breathe out, relax. Breathing open, expand. Breathe out, relax. Breathing open, expand. Breathe out, relax. And then one more time, expand. We bring the hands forward, press into the hips to get that connection, that grounding, and using it to go up like you are building a castle with your spine. Open chest, we put the hands behind, the chest is still open, and we spread. Ah, relax, release, well done. And we will relax both legs, yeah. Oh, well done. So we will go to lying down on the floor now, on the back. Bending your legs, yeah. So connecting deeply the lower back, the hips, expanding your spine, spread your arms, lengthen the back of the neck. Take a moment there to really feel your back, nice and long. Once you feel nice and comfortable there, that you are nice and long, we will start a bridge, pressing with your feet against the floor. Belly is in, we go into the back of the neck and spreading your shoulder blades using shoulders and feet to press into the floor so you can lift in. And then relax, release. Well done. Very nice. Now we will bring the arms beside your body now. Okay. And with the shoulder really rotated back, when we go to the bridge, imagine that you use the whole of your arm to push against the floor to go into the bridge as well. So you use your feet, your arms, and your shoulders when you are on the bridge. Yeah? So, shoulders away, chest is already open, and we go slowly up, belly in, grounding into your arms, grounding into your feet, lengthening the back of the neck, expand. And then relax, release, well done. We will bring the knees to your belly and we soften side to side. Good. We will do the last one here. Yeah? So this time we will put the arms behind you, but nice and open. So you have the whole of the shoulder blade and the shoulder on the floor. Yeah? So nice and comfy. So the arm is on the floor. Yeah? So wherever you can put it there. And then again, we press into the feet, and as you go up, you connect again the back of the neck, and you use your arms also as grounding, lifting, expanding your shoulder blades, expanding the back of the neck. And then relax, release. Soften the lower back there. And we bring the knees to your belly. And we roll side to side. Good. Now we will do the last stretch. Yeah? We will put both hands in one of the knees. Yeah? So we keep this position. And with the other leg, we will extend it forward. Could be touching the floor or not, but really close to the floor if you lift it. The intention is that you ground the lower back and the belly's in. You lengthen your spine. So from the heel to the crown of your head, you lengthen and you try to press it into the floor through the lower back. Yeah? So the heel could be or on the floor or lifted, depending what you need. And you feel, you try to put the lower back on the floor and the back of the neck on the floor. Yeah? And you can even move the foot a little bit side to side to feel the stretching on the groin, but also on the lower back. Yeah? And then relax, bring that knee to your belly. We catch that knee nice and close. Lengthen the back of the neck. We spread the other arm. Sorry, the other leg. Yeah, so check that your lower back is connected. The back of the neck is long. And then you go with the heel forward on the floor or over the floor, like hovering the floor, lengthening, expanding. And then relax, bring both knees. We roll side to side. And we will go to one side to a spinal twist, relaxing your hips opening, surrendering. Relax your shoulder blades, relax your neck, relax your head. And now bring back the images of the roots, the planet beneath you, sending you all the relaxation, the nourishment that you need. All around you, that beautiful loving energy that we always imagine. And imagine receiving all that with each breath. And then slowly we go to the other side, taking your time, expanding and opening. And then slowly we go to the center and we go to Shavasana. Yeah. Good. Cool. So nice and comfy. So visualize again the roots beneath you, the connection with the planet. Imagine receiving all that beautiful nourishing energy, supporting energy, resilience, strength, anything that you could need to add into your energy field. The planet has it all. So imagine that you receive every single thing that you need. And around you, imagine that pink light, yeah, the energy of loving energy, the unconditional loving energy. You can always imagine with that light creating like a beautiful cocoon around you of protection. And if you like, we can add, like what we say at the beginning of the class, you can add around the cocoon or like a beam of light coming from above of a violet light or a violet flame. And the violet light is the energy of transformation, transmutation, pure cleansing. Yeah? So whatever the violet light touch is being transformed in a positive way. Yeah, so it's a beautiful energy to have around more in these times. Yeah? So once you put all those images in place again, soften into the floor, soften into the mat, and imagine that we will receive another extra flow of energy that will fill yourself with relaxation, peace, and comfort. And imagine this energy moving now on the sole of your feet, toward your toes, moving into the front of your feet, your heels, your ankles, your lower legs, your knees and your thighs, your hips, your lower back, middle back, upper back, shoulder blades. Imagine that energy moving into your arms, to your hands, your fingers, going into your wrists, elbows, shoulders, the back of your neck, the back of your head, the crown of your head, your face, your neck, your chest, your belly. Allowing your body to surrender completely to the floor and going deeply inside now and relax, relax, relax. Now slowly, really slowly, allow your awareness to get back to your body and start to bring some movements to your hands, to your feet, moving your fingers, your toes, moving your head side to side, and bringing your arms back and lengthen and stretch. And from there, we fold to one side, we go to a sitting position, crossing your legs, and breathing deeply. Now give a big thanks to yourself for taking the time to come to class. And I thank you for sharing your time and your practice with me.